I am Abu Said Khan, Senior Policy Fellow, Learn Asia. I live in Dhaka, Bangladesh. In Asia, we have witnessed the exploding growth of 2G mobile, but we have not seen similar type of growth in terms of 3G or LTE. The reason is, although Asia is the world's largest landmass and also the home of 60% global population, but these countries are interconnected exclusively through submarine cable. Therefore, the cost of international internet bandwidth has been 6 times higher than what it is in Europe, which has been basically impacting the growth of mobile internet across the developing Asia. And that's why these countries should immediately start deploying cross-border optical fiber infrastructure across Asia. And the best possible way to do is to exploit the right of way of Asian highway, which has been fostered by the UN ESCAP. The 32 Asian countries, starting from Japan to Turkey, crisscrossing 32 countries in between, which also includes Russia, China, India, and many others, this roadway should be the preferred right of way for the pan-Asian optical fiber infrastructure. It will reduce Asia's dependency from submarine cable, which has been prone to natural disaster, man-made sabotage, and other sorts of disruptions. And this highly meshed Asian highway road network shall inherently provide the huge resilience which the telecom infrastructure demands. And it will significantly reduce the cost of wholesale international bandwidth, which will, end of the day, hugely benefit the mobile broadband industry and the consumers, the billions of mobile users across developing Asia.